Today we're talking about Venezuela, a country that's incredibly reliant on liquid assets. Well, one liquid asset. Yes, we're talking about Venezuela today, because the country's caught the eye of John Bolton, a man who, when he's not trying to destroy the economy of Iran, likes to take a vacation and try to destroy the economy of somewhere a little more tropical. The last time I did a report on this, I caught some flack for not being hard enough on Venezuela, with some people even suggesting I was paid by Maduro. Which, yeah, we can't afford to feed our people, but this YouTuber with 367 subscribers, let's make sure to pay him off. Venezuela's economy fell apart because of corruption and mismanagement at high levels. Just wanted to come out and take the bold stance of saying, I'm not pro Maduro's governing and management tactics. I'm bringing John Bolton into the conversation because if you watch a recent video I made documenting the US's sanctions on Iran after we pulled out of the Iran deal and this video at the same time, you're gonna see a pattern emerge. Well, it might not technically be a pattern as it is the exact same thing. It's so intensely similar, people are calling these oil sanctions Iran 2.0. Basically, first we take away your US dollars and then we go after your oil. And finally, the Chinese and Indians swoop in and completely undermine the sanctions. Don't worry, people who are scratching their heads and thinking, wait, I thought this was going to be a Venezuela episode. We're only going to be talking about Venezuela from this point onward. But if you wanted to imagine what a director's cut of this episode would look like, maybe, like John Bolton, keep Iran in the back of your mind at all times. So let's get started with the news, because this country's responding to the US foreign policy like it's a John Bolton fantasy world.
Military leaders support Maduro, the soldiers, maybe not.
What we need is Maduro to leave. We must overthrow this government.
Without the armed forces, President Nicolas Maduro is finished.
Wow, what is happening in Venezuela right now? Today we're going to talk about two big updates. Aid at the Colombian border, and Maduro's scramble for cash. So first the cash scramble, because to keep the lights on in a socialist country, you need money. And unfortunately, when most of your country either has an income of zero or enough money that they're bribing you, income taxes aren't the answer. Instead, Venezuela has traditionally relied on oil revenue from their state-owned oil company, and that worked for a while. Well, I say that, but it's worked in the loosest sense of the term worked. Then, a month ago, the US sanctions hit their oil revenue, just as Juan Guaido was declaring he was the true president of Venezuela, as opposed to Maduro.
Today, and I'll turn the podium over to Steven Mnuchin for this purpose, we're going to announce sanctions against Petróleos de Venezuela, Sociedad Anónima, or PDVSA, as it's known by its Spanish acronym, the state-owned oil monopoly.
Oh man, he does not look natural speaking Spanish. For a while, Venezuela had been struggling to make its payments on oil revenue alone. Rather than go into debt by issuing bonds, they took the risk that brings us to today. They decided to print additional cash to pay the bills. Without going into an absurd amount of detail, this leads to a massive devaluation of their currency.
Venezuela already has the world's highest inflation, and it looks like the economic crisis there is about to get even worse. The International Monetary Fund projects the country's inflation rate will rise to an incomprehensible 1,000,000% by the end of the year.
1,000,000%? That is incomprehensible. Basically, that would mean that by the end of the year, your savings would be worth 1,000,000th of what it was when you started the year. To put that another way, you're starting the year off on the right foot. You've got $1,000,000 in the bank and everything's ready to go. But at the end of that year, you would have $1 in the bank. In socialist Venezuela, everybody has the same amount of money. None. This was helped by the fact that a year ago, the US imposed a financial blockade against Venezuela, which led to their country having a record low foreign currency reserves. Although if you have a dollar in Venezuela, it's worth a lot more than a dollar anywhere else, because it might be the only asset not depreciating by 1,000,000%. So this leads to the question of, how can Maduro get the money to keep the lights on? Oil sales are down quite a bit after the U.S. sanctions. He can't keep up the strategy of printing money because, and this is true, even after his strategy of just cutting off 5 zeros from all the currencies so that your $5 bill is now actually worth $500,000, although it's still just 500,000 worthless bolivars, it didn't do anything. So what can Maduro do? Well, as any person on their last leg would do,
it is money with gold at an all-time high. Now's the time to send your unwanted gold for cash.
Oh no, Maduro. I know you're bad with money, but not cash for gold. Well, too late, because in the past year, Maduro sold 40% of Venezuela's gold reserves in an attempt to get currency that was worth actual money to keep paying people and keep the lights on. In fact, it was reported yesterday that... Oh, no, really? Well, okay. Just the other day, he removed 8 tons of gold to be sold illegally abroad. To put that into perspective, I looked it up, and the average African elephant weighs between 2.5 and 7 tons. So that's more than an elephant's worth of gold. You could pay a Bond villain not to destroy the world with that much gold and still have some left over for a celebratory party. So that's how Maduro's going to try to weather the storm based on the lack of oil revenue and foreign currency. Well, that and China and India are continuing to buy Venezuelan oil. Although it's at such a discount that even a cash for gold buyer would scoff and tell them to be more moral. So this brings us to the other major conflict going on in Venezuela right now. What's up with this aid?
A standoff over humanitarian aid deepens as Venezuela's political crisis plays out on the country's border. A convoy with desperately needed aid remains stuck at the Colombian border city of Cúcuta. Now, Venezuela's government, led by Nicolas Maduro, has ordered the army not to allow this aid in.
I suspect he continued by saying, "Let them eat cake." So why block aid to people who might stop hating you as much if they weren't on the brink of starvation? Well, Maduro is accusing the US of fabricating a crisis so he can go to war with Venezuela. But you listen here, mister, when the US fabricates a crisis, we use it to fund unpopular and expensive infrastructure projects only. More to the point though, it would undermine the credibility of the Venezuelan government. Let me put it this way. Say, and I'm only using this name because he's the president, so don't eviscerate me in the comments, but let's say Donald Trump completely mishandles the economy, to the point where a lot of people are starving in the streets. Speaker Pelosi starts talking about election meddling and claims herself to be the real president, because of the constitutional line of succession. And, oh, you know what? She coordinated with the Europeans who are gonna save us all under her name, because they recognize her as our official president. Well, that border wouldn't be closed before you could finish saying build the wall. Now, you might be saying, nah, I think Bolton and Pompeo are sending aid over there because they're really concerned about the livelihood of the struggling Venezuelans. And if you actually believe that, I think Maduro has some bolivars he'd like to sell you. Just let him fire up the old inkjet printer to make them. This one's hot off the presses, and for you, I added an extra zero. Still though, not a great look for Maduro.
Maduro says the aid is a precursor to an American invasion and continues to pledge to keep the assistance out. Earlier, opposition leader Juan Guaido appeared in Cúcuta with the presidents of Colombia and Paraguay and called on troops and supporters of Maduro to allow the aid into Venezuela.
Now it's a weird situation where there are all these aid trucks stacking up at the Colombian-Venezuelan border because the Venezuelan army won't let them enter. Some Venezuelan armed forces are beginning to cross the border and defect because their families don't have food and medicine, which is the opposite of what Maduro wants. Most famously, this group of 3 Venezuelan armed forces defected and rushed the border in a truck.
Maduro says the aid is a precursor to an American invasion and continues to pledge to keep the assistance out. Earlier, opposition leader Juan Guaido appeared in Cúcuta with the presidents of Colombia and Paraguay and called on troops and supporters of Maduro to allow the aid into Venezuela.
This brings us to the crux of the episode, because one group is the popular group that everybody wants to be friends with, the armed forces. On one side, you have Juan Guaido offering amnesty and aid, and on the other side, you have Maduro offering some of the fattest checks that 8 tons of gold can buy. As tensions ramp up, both at the border with Colombia and in the budgeting meetings in Venezuela, the question on everybody's minds is who do the men with the guns want to lead the country? Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.